life and to help us. If we forget sometimes, don't we, that Christ himself asks the same why as we do, in his final agony on the cross. My God, why have you forsaken me? And this mystery of pain and suffering will never be fully answered here on this earth. But what we can say is that God never directly wills pain and suffering on us. But such are the natural consequences of us having free will and the ability to make choices. Because God could have chosen to create a creature that would never be sick, that would never suffer, that would never have pain, that would always be perfect. But that creature would not be human. It would be a robot or a perfectly tuned machine. And who would want to live like that? No, to be human gives us opportunities each and every day to love, to live, to give, to forgive, to fall and to fail, to get up again, and you. John had this understanding of the way God had created us. And I used to marvel at John that even in his lowest ebb, he never raged against God, as I think I would if I were in his shoes. I never heard him blame God or say, poor me. But right up to the end, he had such a profound faith, hope, and trust in this God who he had devoted his life to and in his blessed mother. One of John's sayings that deep down he believed and lived was, praise God in all things. Praise God in all things. This goes way back to St. Paul, through to St. Francis of Assisi, St. Ignatius of Loyola, our own beloved founders, St. Damien of Molokai, and found in that great classic of Christian spirituality, abandonment to divine providence. And oh my God, how this was tested over the past year. We will never fully know what poor John had to endure in his body, in his soul, and in his spirit, in his nights of Gethsemane, as he struggled and suffered and continued to say, praise God in all things, even this. And a few months before Father John returned to his Lord in a quiet time together in the hospital, he turns to me and says, you know, Michael, two things have sustained me throughout this illness: my faith and my family. And my God, how true that is. I don't think I've ever witnessed a family so committed, so loving, and so attentive to a brother as John's siblings were to him over those long months of 2017. No wonder there are so many here tonight, and why so many came to the last Mass, not just to remember, to pray, and to give thanks to God for John, but also to meet and give thanks and applaud John's wonderful brother and sisters, who gave so much of themselves at great personal cost to make sure John was never alone, to remind him of how much he was loved and appreciated, and to make sure he had everything he needed. They might say they were just doing what any family would do in the circumstances, but we all know their love was exemplary and their care too, right up into the early hours of the 27th November, when with praying and singing and thanksgiving and tears both of sadness and joy, they loved John into eternal life, giving him back to God, who had first given him to them. At the Monks Mind Mass for John last Saturday week back in his hometown of Barry Bay, I got chatting to the two young servers beforehand as they got ready. They looked alike, so I asked them if they were brother and sister. No, they said. Cousins? No. Neighbors? No. I was getting a bit desperate at this stage. Classmates? No. So then I said, that brainwave. Friends? There was a big long pause. And one of them said, kind of. I'm sure John was smiling down and laughing at this little interaction. I mention this because John wasn't kind of a friend to others. He was a friend to so many, many of whom are gathered here tonight. Remember him, pray for him, meet his family. But this friendship was particularly evident to the poor and to those in need, which is why he flourished and gave so much of himself to those who needed his help here at Acton, and before that in Nunhead. John knew at a heart's level the gospel imperative, that what we do for the least of our sisters and brothers, we do for Christ. No wonder then that in the early hours, 27th of November, not only was Christ and his Blessed Mother accompanying John, not only his beloved parents, but also the countless people John had helped and listened to and affirmed throughout his life and ministry. I want to leave you with a few lines from a poem entitled Inherit the Kingdom. And you'll have no difficulty in applying the lines to our beloved brother, uncle, priest.